I invite you to please stand as you are able and welcome the Holy Childhood of Jesus Church. I'm Father Joe Graff, the ex-pastor, now retired. Father James is here with us today, the current pastor. We gather near the baptismal font as we begin the funeral of our sister Fay, because it was at the baptismal font that God first called her by name and made her his daughter. And so as we begin our sacred celebration, we first sprinkle the casket with the holy water that reminds us of her baptism. And then her family will clothe the casket with the white cloth that reminds us of her baptismal robe. So we pray as we do all things in God's name, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Fay died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Thank you. You to please be seated as Fay's four sons share some remarks of remembrance with us.
Good morning. Thank you all for coming today. As we celebrate the life of Fay FitzSimons Buhl, mother, daughter, wife, aunt, cousin, grandmother, friend, community leader, and boss. She was these things and so much more to all of us. She grew up in Grosse Pointe Farms, attended the Academy of the Sacred Heart, graduated from Manhattanville College, and 64 years ago, Mom and Dad got married right here in this church. Not so long after, Mom took the job of mother of four boys. Enough said.
This is a morning prayer that was one of Mom's prayers that she read every day. Oh God, help me to live one day at a time, not thinking of what might have been and not worrying about what might be. Help me to accept the fact that I cannot foresee the future and I cannot undo the past. And even as I think of this, and even as I face today, help me always to remember that I will never be tried beyond what I can bear. So help me live today with courage and hopefulness and in peace. Amen.
We'd now like to share a few of our thoughts that we've had to help describe our mom. We've added a sampling of thoughts of things we've heard from our friends and extended family over the last few days as well. Awesome mom. Amazing grandmother. Crazy granny. Lab lover. Always called me by name. Athlete in field hockey, golf, tennis, shooting. Her drink of choice, Crystal Palace. Pinnacle of kindness, blessed a lot of our lives. Made me always feel welcome and made sure I had a blast. Never forgot a birthday or an anniversary, and that included all of our friends. Michigan's first citizen. Casual elegance. Always thinking of others. An early adopter of FOMO. She never wanted to miss an event. Great lady. Classy lady. Family historian, Buhl and FitzSimons side. Enthusiasm for adventure and life. No fanfare, did so much for so many, quietly. Devout Catholic, a dame of Malta. Always such a guiding light for so many of us. And the list could go on and on. Thank you.
We'd like to give a special thanks to Nina, Carrie, Carol, Cynthia, and Louie for being such great helpers for Mom over these past few months. We'd also like to thank all the wonderful people at Harbor Point Association, Northern Michigan Hospitals, as well as all our doctors and all the wonderful caregivers for everything that they've done for Mom and Dad over the last few years. And lastly, thanks to all the people in Harbor Springs community that have meant so much to Mom. After the service, please join us for perch fry, appropriately, at our farm to enjoy the outdoors. Directions will be by the book in the back of the church for those who do not know where we're headed, but we certainly would welcome everybody. We would suggest that you go home after the service and put on some warm and comfortable clothes. So, thank you.
Our final thought. Dad always asked us to look after Mom and put her first. But in reality, she was the one that took care of us and put us first. We love you, Mom. See you in our dreams.
Let us stand and pray. God of our ancestors in faith, by the covenant made on Mount Sinai, You taught your people to strengthen the bonds of family through faith, honor, and love. Look kindly upon Fay, a mother who sought to bind her children to you. Bring her one day to our heavenly home, where the saints dwell in blessedness and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And I invite you to please be seated. And let us be attentive to the word of God as Amanda proclaims our first reading.
Reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard a voice from heaven say, "Write this: Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on." "Yes," said the Spirit. "Let them find rest from their labors, for their works accompany them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Ending. The Lord
my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
And let us continue to be attentive to the word of God as Jeffrey proclaims our second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life. Why then do you judge your brother or you? Why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God." So then each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And I invite you to stand with me as we proclaim the presence of the Lord Jesus.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Let word be upon our minds, upon our lips, and in our hearts. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visited you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did it for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison, and you did not care for me. Then they will answer and say, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger or naked, or ill or in prison, and not minister to your needs? He will answer them, Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me. And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated.
See how lucky you are. You have a new pastor who sings well. Today is one of those bittersweet days for those of us who are believers. You know, the sadness of separation so well expressed by Amanda as she proclaimed our first reading, and the tears that she said she shed because of her love for her grandmom, which I'm sure you had all these sisters, brothers, aunts, uncles, moms, and dads in your heart when that happened. And Jeffrey, who proclaimed that wonderful truth and proclaimed it so well, we are God's. We belong to God. To let that truth seep down inside us, both in life and in death, we are God's. And what that tells us is that God is with us every moment of this life, and when we die and move on to the next, he is still with us, because we then are even more strongly with him. Today is a day of great loss and sadness, but even more so, as you could tell by the noise back in the narthex, a day of joy and excitement. Because she who has died is risen. She is with the Lord now in paradise. She's there because she was a woman of faith, and a faith so deep in Jesus Christ that she couldn't keep it to herself. It overflowed in her into so many other areas. The people whose lives she touched by her generosity, but especially her generosity of spirit. She never hesitated to go to the hospital with Holy Communion, to visit those who are hungering for their Lord in their pain and in their confusion. And Fay was always willing to go there to be with them, to share that very truth that we are God's, as she shared with them the body of Christ in the hospital. And so many other things that Fay did that touched the lives of other people by faith. And I dare to say that I know almost none of them, because she never bragged. The Lord Jesus told us, do Christian works of love and mercy because you are merciful and because you love. Don't do them to be seen, to be praised, because if you do it for that reason, you have already received your reward. But if you do it with love, if you do it with faith, not for praise, then Jesus tells us your reward will be great in heaven. You see, these are the things that Fay not only believed, but practiced. And in practicing them, her reward in heaven is assured. You are among the most blessed people I know, all of you Buhl boys, and all you grandchildren, and all you relatives, David and Joan and Michael, and your families. Because this was a woman, just by her very presence, at least to me, and if to me, a comparative stranger, I would think certainly to you, transferred into your life a sense of peace and a sense of faith and a sense of responsibility to those who are less fortunate, not to get praise, but because God wants us to do it. Because every time we do something in love and generosity, we do it as God. People experience that wonder of God's love in the gentleness of a person who does what she does, what he does, out of love, out of compassion, not for honor or glory or praise. And this was one of, in my humble opinion, one of many of Fay's great attributes. I can never remember walking into her house and not have a deep sense of being welcomed. She made everyone feel significant, important. Not because you are important, but because she cared about everyone and loved everyone. And so if you were a homeless person on the street, you felt as welcomed and loved by her as if you were one of her own children or grandchildren. What a wonderful gift God gave her, and how quietly she lived that gift. So there's going to be a heck of a party after this funeral out at the farm, which I think is absolutely wonderful that you're doing that. Wear your masks and keep socially distanced. I don't want to read about it in the paper. But celebrate the life of this woman. And when you're celebrating her life, you can't help but celebrate Larry's life. That wonderful life of that wonderful man. What a couple they were. Many a times, our closet Catholic Larry would be sick. And I would go over to the hospital or to their home and share the sacrament of the sick with him, because he was a baptized Christian. And I can remember that one time that Fay thought that he was going to pass in the hospital. And the fighting German, I guess, right? Didn't. He bounced back. But you could just see in Fay's eyes the love she has for Larry. It was just awesome to behold. I thought, this is a couple that needs to be the model for a lot of couples because of their love for each other. And if you think of the two of them, then you can't help but think about God, because God is love. And when you gather in love here and at the farm, God is with you. Remember, you are God's. Wherever you go, both in life and in death, you are God's. Be filled with the joy that comes from that. And I'm sure that Fay, from her side, from God's side in heaven, is just pushing down on you all that tremendous amount of love and joy and faith and hope that fills her, that filled her life. And when we gather here, and I'll still be here in 50 years to do Larry's funeral, you know.
I'll take 50.
We will be able to say the same thing about him that we can say about his father and his mother, because he and all of you are God's, and you love him. And I invite you to please stand with me as you are able. And I invite Teddy and Quinn to please come forth to lead us in our intercessions. Brothers and sisters, let us open our hearts to the mercy of God as we lift these prayers for our beloved Fay and all Christians.
In baptism, Grandma received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our grandma was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Grandma seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in the faith and confidence to pray for our sister Grandma. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Loving God, hear the prayers that we raise to you this day. Fill our hearts with a deeper faith and an ever greater joy as we recall Fay and we recall your love for her, for you are Lord forever and ever. And I invite you to please be seated. And as the grandchildren bring forth our gifts, please also offer yourself as our gift to our God. sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you. Please stand as you are able and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant and daughter, Fay, may be taken up to glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying may be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling lies, it turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
And please kneel as you are able. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O God, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession and your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant, Francis our Pope, our apostolic administrator, Bishop Walter, and the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant and daughter, Fay, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be with him in the resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh all who have died and transform our lowly body into the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand as you are able. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And share with each other on this day a sign of Christ's peace. As you are able. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
mighty will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels is given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you, hold you in the palm of his hand. Thank you.
And let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Fay may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Father of mercies, we commend our sister Fay in the sure and certain hope that, together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Fay in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and daughter Fay, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister Fay forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and your families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go forth in joy and in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be, with God as our Father. Brothers, all are we. Let me walk with my
Ante